Larson loops are not credits. Larson loops are not credits. They will never be credits. Well met, travelers. We are about 2 hours north of Atlanta at a little amusement park that has been here a long time, tucked away up here near the Tennessee border, called Lake Winnipesaukee, also known as Lake Winnie. Larson Luke behind me. Don't know if I'll be doing that. Is it a credit? Is it not? No, not really, even with RMC involved. So, the main reason I'm here is that they have a roller coaster, a classic roller coaster built in 1967, same year that Six Flags Over Georgia opened, fun fact, by the Philadelphia Toboggan Company. Now that coaster is called Cannonball. Hits about 50 miles per hour, 70 foot tall first drop. At the time, it was a monster, and it's still running today. And I don't have the credit. It's an ACE landmark, it's a real deal classic, still operating Woody. And that's mainly what I'm here for. I'm gonna do a couple of other things just to make it worth my time, but that's about it. We're here to have some fun, mix things up, and let's get to it. I'm not sure just how many rides are open today. I've heard this thing is absolutely nuts. It mostly looks like old carnival rides and stuff. And yeah, they are visibly old. But it's charming. And in classic fashion, the park does feature a lake, Lake Winnipesaukee, of course, as its centerpiece. They even have a little sky ride going over the lake, which appears to be stalled. Oh, nope. There it goes. I do like that the swinging ship is actually on the lake. You can even rent boats here to paddle out on the lake. How classic is that? And if you look right over there, they have a very bizarre and unique log flume ride that actually drops you into the lake itself. That's another thing I very much want to do. And hey, free Wi-Fi, always a bonus. Now, right now, I am just kind of making my way through the park, trying to get onto the back, which is where Cannonball is. Oh, there we go. I see it. I was thinking about putting it off till later, but you know what? It's open. There's not much of a line. Let's do this. Iowa, baby! So, that is a surprisingly good classic Woody. I get why it's a landmark. It is also the oldest wooden coaster in Georgia. A lot of surprising airtime moments. Of course, it's a little rough. It's an older Woody, it happens. Can't complain too much about that, but it feels like it's in pretty good shape, and it is a fun ride. I had to take the overshirt off. It's a little warm. Let's do some exploring. You know what, whatever. I'm gonna go again. I'm right here. Let's do it again. All right, so that is two rides on Cannonball. Ran into some other thuzies here. You know, I even like that more the second time. I think I like that more than Scream Machine, which I don't love in the first place, but this is a This is a very good old school woody. It's got some really interesting elements for an older woody as well. There's an angle to the first drop, which is interesting for an old woody. I know it's not impossible or completely uncommon, but you don't see it terribly often. It's always a nice little element on these. Well, yeah, let's do some exploring, as I said. I don't have a ton of time here today. I want to get a look around this park. I definitely want to do that log flume. So let's go have some fun. Said there's a ton of just old school carnival rides in here. You know what? I kind of want to ride this. I think I'm going to ride this. Also, I'm sure you've probably seen it mentioned in other videos, but this place's trash cans are scary clowns, and that's an interesting choice. You know what? This thing was actually shockingly fun. Well, what did they call it? I know it's a, I can't remember the style of ride right now. I know it has a name. Orbiter is the name of the ride, but I can't remember the model of this ride, but it is a fun ride. Give it a shot if you see one of these. And away we go over Lake Winnie. Yeah, this is a little bit nervous. Holy crap. Look at those fish. Can you see the size of those things? Wow. Those are some big boys. But yeah, we are currently out over the lake. I heard stories before that back in the day, people used to take this thing out right here to the middle of the lake and then jump into the water. I'm good, dog. I don't think that's allowed anymore, obviously, but yeah, no thank you. And there's that log flume I was telling y'all about. Look, it literally drops into the lake itself. That's wild. I love it. That is so nuts. I'm excited for that. Cool. We are now on the other side of the lake, and I actually thought that this dropped you off on this side, but it turns out we're just gonna do a full loop around. So that's fine. I'll go back around and make my way back around to the flume. At least I got some cool views, right? That is, I still can't believe people used to jump off that into the water. That's bouncy. You're bouncy. See you on the other side, I guess. And the turnaround. What up? This is very relaxing. And like I said, beautiful views of the park. There's a dark ride over there too. If I'm not mistaken, it's a classic Sally. I could be wrong on that. I think it had a re-theme from a horror kind of vibe into Wacky Factory. Maybe we can get a try at that as well. The size of these fish is blowing my mind. Look at these things. Those are huge. Cool, man. Good view of Cannonball from up here too. Anyway, back into the home base. Well, it's a wacky worm, but hey, a credit's a credit, right? All right, there's your wacky worm knocked out. Like I said before, hey, a credit's a credit, right? It actually was a fairly forceful wacky worm, believe it or not. Not anything crazy, of course, but I can see kids getting a little taste for the thrill on that thing, getting bit by the coaster bug, if you will. Let's figure out what to do next. You know what, I'm here, and it's a classic dark ride. Let's go for it. I like the aluminum foil. Is that Leatherface? I thought this was a wacky factory. What? This is an interesting mix of themes. Psychedelic. Oh, okay. And there we have it. Pretty solid classic dark ride. I enjoyed it. That's a cute little classic dark ride. Like I said, I think it might be a Sally. I think it is. But I'm not positive on that. Don't quote me. I guess we're going to make our way over to the log flume now. I am running short on time, but trying to squeeze in as much as I can, and no, I'm not doing the Larson loop. It's not a coaster. Ah, here we are. The boat chute. This is so wild. Look at this. The water for this, it's literally the lake. It comes right up here to the concrete. You could just walk right in. I mean, it's against the rules, and I wouldn't, but wow. Okay. So cool. That is some foreboding noise. Refreshing lake water. Yeah, that was super cool. I wasn't expecting a chain lift hill either. Also, the tunnel, most of the ride is an enclosed tunnel. It's like pitch Vanta black in there. There's no theming, no music, no nothing. Just a pitch black, eerie tunnel. It's really cool. I liked it. So I went ahead and grabbed myself a t-shirt, and I think we're about done here for today. But there is one last thing I want to do. And it's this wild guy right here, another one that I'm struggling to remember the model of. But let's do it. I'll look it up later. Okay, so that thing is crazy. And actually, while I was on the ride, I remembered, it's a topspin. It's just a smaller, kind of wilder version of a topspin. I don't know how I didn't think of that at the time. That is one of the wilder things I've done. That topspin is nuts. Like, really good. I'd do it again, but I don't have time. Lord, let's call it a day at Lake Winnie. Head on back out. Larson loops are not credits. Larson loops are not credits. They will never be credits. On our way back out of Lake Winnie, folks, it's been fun. All right, so that is going to do it for Lake Winnipesaukee Amusement Park, right at the Tennessee-Georgia border here near Chattanooga on the Georgia side. It's a fun little theme park. And Cannonball is great. I really, really like Cannonball. If I had more time, I'd do it a few more times, but I don't. Glad to get the credit, though. Got the Wacky Worm credit, I guess. And that topspin is wild. So, yeah. If you're driving by here, stop and take a visit. It's a cool little park to hang out in, walk around in, and Cannonball's a cool credit to get. It is an ACE landmark after all. But with that being said, I gotta hit the road. It's been a pleasure having you along with me. So, until we meet again, travelers, Godspeed.